Yesterday, the EThekwini Mayor, Mxolisi Kaunda, tabled his budget policy speech for the city. This morning, he joins us now via Skype to share his plans during this difficult time. Mayor Kaunda, a very good morning to you. Thanks for joining us. Welcome to Morning Live.
Morning, Simpiwe. Thank you for having us in your program, and good morning to your viewers.
It's an absolute pleasure. Now, in your speech, Mayor, yesterday you called for the intensification of the fight against COVID-19 as a city. How do you plan on doing this?
Indeed, it has been a very difficult journey to put this budget together, navigating during this period of COVID-19. And as a city, we have decided that we are not going to be disrupting the service delivery. Yes, we have made some adjustments in the budget so that we are able to cope with the manner in which we collect the revenue. And in terms of waging our fight against COVID-19, we have been on the ground supplying services to our people, especially water, ensuring that the access to clean, potable water to all our informal settlements and deep rural areas. But we have also taken and appreciated the COVID-19 challenges that are presented before us. We have decided that we need to take advantage of the new normal by introducing and re-engineering our procurement system as a municipality so that it does benefit the majority of people in our city. But we have also looked at the infrastructure of our municipality so that we can be able to enhance our own strides in inviting and attracting investments to our city. So these are the kinds of interventions that the budget has put in place, and we are working with all other spheres of government to ascertain that our people are really in their lives during this difficult period of COVID-19. We take care of them, and we also offer some social relief.
You know, Mayor, you've just outlined and articulated some of the social economic challenges, which were, of course, were at the center of your speech yesterday. But I suppose there's nothing new in what you said. I mean, even your predecessors talked about some of these challenges, and there's still no plan to ensure that whatever has been budgeted for, you know, is channeled towards poverty eradication. So how do you plan on tackling this?
There is something new in the plan we presented yesterday. Firstly, we have declared that the mayor should be leading the job creation and skills revolution war room, which will be charged with the responsibility to make assessments on weekly and monthly basis and quarterly basis to ascertain that we are making impact in delivering on the expected jobs that must be created in the city. But we have also intervened in terms of the procurement, and we said we need to re-engineer it in such a way that cooperatives and social enterprises should now find an opportunity being given through our own procurement systems so that we are expanding the beneficiation to those who have been locked out of the mainstream economy. Those are the changes. But we have also tapped into the issue of technology, that we are a smart city. We need to be preparing ourselves so that we are able to attract more investment when it comes to technology and other aspects of IT in the city. We have also decided as a city that we need to take decisive action in terms of infrastructure development. So hence, we'll be working together with the private sector to ascertain that the youth of our city, we start industrializing. We've been talking about job creation, but in this program, we have defined how the youth will access those jobs and how those jobs should then be rolled out so that our unemployed youth can be able to get into the labor market.
Now, speaking of jobs and job creation, I want to refer you to the KZN Poverty Eradication Master Plan of 2014, which is not a panacea on its own, but it is basically a modest measure on tackling poverty and eradicating poverty in the province by the year 2020, and also ostensibly trying to move the poor away from the dependency on the state and promote self-sustainability. Now, the issue of self-sustainability remains a pipe dream, if I would call that at this stage, and made worse by COVID-19. Just looking at the trends, Mayor, do you think that you are well on course to ensure that people are self-sustainable?
Yes, we are. We have already developed our business cases, which indicate that how do we then advance the economy of township and rural economies so that those who have been unemployed in those areas are now drawn into the labor market, but through the business opportunities as well that will be availed by enhancing our industrialization plan. Because for the malls that are being constructed in areas, in township and deep rural areas, we are not expecting our people to continue to be employed as general workers and security people, but we want them to be the producers of the material that will be needed in those construction so that they partake on the value addition of our economy. And we have also engaged the private sector through our webinar and other business forums that they should start also embarking on our call and adhere to it, that let's work together during the launch of our economic council of our city. We'll be able to engage them and put clear plans with clear targets to ascertain that we also adhere to the broad-based back economic charters that they are required to respond to.
All right, Mayor Kaunda, thank you so much for your time. Thank you for chatting to us this morning.
Thank you.